Welcome to the video presentation of modeling mechanical signals on the surface of MicroCT and CAD-based rapid prototype scaffold models to predict early tissue development, to be published in Biotechnology and Bioengineering by Wim Hendrickson. For more than 100 years ago, the link between mechanical loading and tissue formation was suggested. Kuhlmann and Meyer saw the remarkable resemblance between stress lines in the crane and the femur. In the 60s, Powles introduced the idea of certain stresses and strains responsible for specific tissue type formation. Sometime later, finite element was employed to definitely link mechanical loading with tissue formation. With the arrival and application of finite element modeling, several mechanoregulation theories were postulated. Combinations of mechanical stimuli, fluid flow and shear stress or strain results in different tissues being formed and remodeled until an equilibrium occurred. Among them was the theory of Carter, who included good vascularity as a prerequisite for bone formation. In short, their hypothesis says that bone is formed when there is a good blood supply and minimal cyclic stresses. According to Carter, an increase in stress results in cartilage, while a further stress increase results in fibrous tissue. Some years later, Klaas and Heikler postulated their theory. They did not agree with the lack of investigation of local deformations and the prediction of the type of tissue formation from these stimuli. They stated that new bone formation will form along fronts of existing bone or calcified tissue, and that intramembranous bone formation or endochondral ossification depends on the local strain and stress magnitude. However, shortly after Klaas and Heikler, Prendergast postulated his theory. He considered tissue composed of a fluid and solid phase. Shear strain and fluid flow could predict cell differentiation and the eventual tissue formed. A study performed by Cayeri et al. Compared the different theories, and the theory of Prendergast was the best approximation with experimental data. Based on this, the theory is the most established for linking mechanical stimuli with tissue formation. Therefore, it is often used for modeling tissue formation inside tissue engineering scaffolds. Models in literature take the deformation of the biomaterial, as shown in B, represented by the elements on the surface of the model, in which we termed volumetric strains, to predict cell differentiation and tissue formation. However, the strain of the surface, as shown in A, is not taken into account, which would be a better representation of the deformation sensed by cells attached to the surface. In a simple experiment in which the top node of a tetrahedra was displaced, the shear strain for the entire element, as shown in D, and for the separate element faces, as shown in C, were calculated. As can be seen in C and D, the magnitudes are significantly different. To understand the effect of surface strains and volumetric strains, scaffolds with controlled architecture were obtained through 3D fused deposition modeling. Finite element models were derived from micro-CT scans of the scaffold. Scaffolds were subjected to a compressive strain of 10% applied at the top of the scaffold. Here you can appreciate the difference in magnitude between the surface strain shown in B, octahedral shear strain shown in C, and the volumetric strain shown in D. Mechanical strain acts at the crossing of the fibers and extends towards the center of the pore along the bottom and top part of the fiber. Fluid flow was simulated as it was applied from the top of a scaffold to the bottom. A is a side view, C is a top view, while B and D are close-ups. Fluid shear stress acts at the side of the wall, which is in contrast with the mechanical strain. For illustrative purposes, the theory of Prendergast was used to show the effect of strain calculation on cell differentiation in the initial states of tissue formation. The top row shows cell differentiation based on mechanical strain only. The bottom row is a mechanical strain and fluid shear stress. Each column depicts the influence of the strain calculation. Octahedral shear strain has a higher strain, which results in more fibrous tissue and even cell death at some locations. For surface shear strain, the majority is cartilage, with small parts of bone being present. For more information, please see our article at Biotechnology and Bioengineering or contact us through email. Thank you very much.